of the garden, God said, ye shall not eat of it, neither shall ye touch it, lest ye die. And the serpent said unto the woman, ye shall not surely die, for God doth know that in the day ye eat thereof, then your eyes shall be opened, and ye shall be as gods, knowing good and evil. And when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, that it was pleasant to the eye, and a tree to be desired to make one wise, she took of the fruit thereof and did eat, and gave also unto her husband with her. And the eyes of them both were open, and they knew that they were naked. And they sewed fig leaves together and made themselves aprons. And they heard the voice of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And Adam and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God amongst the trees of the garden. And the Lord God called unto Adam and said unto him, where art thou? And he said, I heard thy voice in the garden, and I was afraid, because I was naked, and I hid myself. And he said, who told thee that thou wast naked? Hast thou eaten of the tree whereof I command thee that thou shouldest not eat? And the man said, the woman whom thou gavest to me to be with me, she gave me of the tree, and I did eat. And the Lord God said to the woman, what is this that thou hast done? And the woman said, the serpent beguiled me, and I did eat. And the Lord God said unto the serpent, because thou hast done this, thou art cursed above all cattle and above every beast of the field. Upon thy belly shalt thou go, and dust shalt thou eat all the days of thy life. And I will put enmity between thee and the woman, and between thy seed and her seed. It shall bruise thy head, and thou shalt bruise his heel. Unto the woman he said, I will greatly multiply thy sorrow and thy conception. In sorrow shalt thou bring forth children, and thy desire shall be to thy husband, and he shall rule over thee. And unto Adam he said, because thou hast hearkened unto the voice of thy wife, and hast eaten of the tree of which I commanded thee, thou shalt not eat of it. Cursed is the ground for thy sake. In sorrow shalt thou eat of it all the days of thy life. Thorns also and thistles shall it bring forth to thee, and thou shalt eat the herb of the field. In the sweat of thy face shalt thou eat bread, till thou return unto the ground. For out of it wast thou taken, for dust thou art, and unto dust thou shalt return. And Adam called his wife's name Eve, because she was the mother of all living. Unto Adam also, and to his wife, did the Lord God make coats of skins, and clothed them. And the Lord God said, behold, the man is become as one of us, to know good and evil. Now lest he put forth his hand, and take also of the tree of life, and eat, and live forever. Therefore the Lord God sent him forth from the Garden of Eden to till the ground from whence he was taken. So he drove out man, and placed at the east of the Garden of Eden cherubims and a flaming sword, which turned every way to keep the way of the tree of life. That is why we and all of mankind needed the Messiah. So like I said, for 4,000 years, men watched and waited and looked for this Messiah to come. Let's sing about that, can we?
Thank you.
and bear a son. And they shall call his name Emmanuel, which is translated,
God with us.
Thank you. And the song is "The Snow Lay on the Ground." Now, there has to be something in everyone that we do, a new one that we have to talk about. Did anybody here have Latin in high school? Do I see somebody over here maybe a little Latin? Yeah, okay. But I didn't either, but I appreciate the Latin. And one of the reasons I chose this hymn was because of the Latin. Now, on your handout, they have it in large print. There's three words that we want to learn how to say in Latin. Will you do that with me? Learn how to say them? The very first one is venite.
Venite.
And if you look at the pronunciation guide, it says V-E-H-N-E-E-T-E-H. Venite. Does that sound okay?
Yeah.
Now let's say it together. Venite. Venite. Now, of course, I was going to go around and make each person say it, but I...
Thank you.
remembering back what happened there in Bethlehem, and the first Advent, he was coming in the world for the first time. But the Lord tells us there's actually going to be three different. There's going to be a first coming, a second coming, and right in the middle there's going to be another thing that's called the rapture of the church, where Jesus doesn't actually come to the world, but he appears in the air. And I'm kind of going to skip over a little of that. You all know the Christmas story. You know that Jesus has come, the Messiah has come. He gave himself on the cross of Calvary to make it possible for anyone and everyone to come back into fellowship with God and to give glory and praise to him. I want to remind you of what Jesus himself said in John chapter 14 when he left this world, okay? He came into the world as a babe, grew until he was 30-some years old, about 30-plus. At 33-plus, he gave himself on the cross of Calvary as a sacrifice for our sins. He died physically. He was buried. He rose again. He spent another 40 days showing himself to people in this world, proving that he had risen. He had conquered death. He had paid the sin debt. And then he ascended back to glory, where he is right now. He sits at the right hand of God the Father as our advocate. Okay? And before he went up, he talked to his disciples there. John chapter 14, verse 1. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. Now, folks, that is what we await. 4,000 years, the Old Testament Christian or believers were waiting for the coming of Messiah. We today await his second coming. And like I said, the very first part of that is going to be appearing in the air, and everyone that's accepted what he did on the cross of Calvary, you want to read about that, go to John chapter 3 and read what Jesus said to Nicodemus, okay? You must be born again. All born-again children of God will be caught up together with him in the air. And there we shall be ever with the Lord, it says here. Okay? I also want to take you over to the book of 1 Thessalonians chapter 4. Because God, through Paul, gave us hope. As a matter of fact, at the end of the scripture it says, wherefore, comfort one another with these words. Okay? And it talks about that time when Jesus will appear in the air. Verse 13, chapter 4, 1 Thessalonians. But I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that you sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so then also them which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you, by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, and the voice of the archangel, and the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds, to meet the Lord in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord. And all of God's people said,
Amen.
Amen.